maths. You know, yesterday we have started practice 4.8, practice 4.8, right? In which we are learning the word problems based on the multiplication, the real life situation where we need to perform the operation of multiplication, right? So today we are going to continue it and we are going to solve the remaining problems in this practice. Okay, so see question number 6. A packet has 1000 typing sheets. A packet has 1000 typing sheets. How many sheets will 274 such packets have? Same situation where, as I said yesterday, when there is given for one, and asking for many, which operation we have to do? Multiplication. Multiplication. Which operation we have to do? Multiplication. Okay? When there is given for one, asking for many, in that case, we have to perform multiplication. So, see here, is there a similar situation? A packet means one packet has. In one packet, there are 1000 typing sheets. Typing sheets means the sheets we use to type. Okay? And we take Xerox or print that sheets. Okay? So, in that one packet, there are 1000 typing sheets, and how many sheets will 274 such packets will have? Or if means what? If there are 274 such packets, if there are 274 such packets, then total how many typing sheets will be there in that 274 packets? That we have to find. So is there similar situation for one asking for many? We'll be right back. How many members are there in our group? 96, right? Members means what? Person. Number of person. Then we have to find members in 300 groups. How many? Okay. Members in a group means one group, 96. Members in 300 such groups? 5. We have to find. So given, this is given. Given for a group means one group, asking for 300 group. Okay. So given for one, asking for many. So which operation we are going to do here? Yes, same. Multiplication. That is 96 multiplied by 300. Again, I have written this way horizontally. You have got to know, I think. You see, this 300 is what? Multiple of 10 as there is 0 at the end. Okay? So we are not going to multiply by log multiplication method. We are going to multiply using the tree. What we are going to do? These two zeros first right here. And 96 multiplied by 3. 96 threes are. 3 6 is 18, 1 carry, 3 9 is 37 and 1 28. Correct? 3 6 is 18, 3 9 is 27 and 1 28. So 288 right here. So there are 28,000. There are 28,800 people or members in 300 groups. Okay? So in this way we have to solve these examples. Now pause this video and write this in your notebook. Okay? Two more word problems we will see. See a problem number 10. A pharmacy can produce 6,000 capsules in every hour or every hour. How many capsules will he produce in 3 hours? Okay. So see here, directly I have taken problem number 10. Previously we have solved problem number 6 and 7. So 8 and 9 you have to solve by yourself as a homework. Okay, it's very easy. So see 10th one, a pharmacy can produce 6,000 capsules in every hour. Every hour indicates 1 hour. So capsules produced in 1 hour Every hour indicates 1 hour, okay? How many? 6,000. Again, there is 0,0 at the end, that means this multiplication is going to be easy. And we have to find capsules. Oh, it's not working. Capsules produced in 30 hours. How many? So again, see, given for every hour. Every hour means 1 hour. Given for 1, asking for 30 means many. Okay? Given for 1, asking for many. Which operation? Multiplication. Again, see, there is 0 at the end, there are zeros at the end. So this multiplication we have to perform using the tree. Okay? What we are going to do, both numbers are multiples of 10. Both the numbers, multiplicand and multiplier, both the numbers are multiples of 10. So, first count zeros in both the numbers. Here 1, 2, 3 and here 1. Total 4 zeros right here. And multiply 6 and 3. 6 threes are 18. So, 1 10 is 100, 1000, 10,000 lakh. So, how many capsules will it produce? It will produce, means that pharmacy, it will produce 1,80,000 80,000 capsules in 30 hours. Okay? See, 11th one. This is hot question. Hot means higher order thinking question. Higher order thinking question means we have to think lot for this. It is based on multiplication only, but we have to do many calculations there. We have to understand the concept. There is part of intelligence also. See, in a sale, a shirt costs rupees 600 and a trouser rupees 1400. However, if you buy a pair of shirt and trouser together, then you have to pay rupees 1800. How much does a person pay to buy 12 shirts and 10 trousers? Okay, so that person wants to buy 12 shirts and 10 trousers. Then how many rupees he has to pay? Now read the problem carefully. See the conditions. It's a sale. The sale is going on in the market, global market. Okay. If you purchase only shirt, then you have to pay rupees 600. See, a shirt rupees 600. Then a trouser rupees 1400. If you purchase only trouser separately, then you have to pay rupees 1400. But there is one discount, or maybe we can say, if you purchase shirt and pant together, so shirt and trouser together, shirt plus trouser means if pair, this is pair, shirt and trouser together, then how much rupees you have to pay? Rupees 1800. Is there a discount on this? Yes, see na. If individual shirt you are purchasing, then you have to pay 600, and individual pant and trouser 1400. Okay, so 1400 plus 600, total 2000. Separately, if you purchase one shirt and one trouser separately, then you have to pay 2000. But both the shirt and trouser, if you are purchasing in pair together, then you have to pay rupees 1800, right? That means 200 rupees discount is there. Now see that person wants to buy 12 shirts and 10 trousers. So 12 shirts and 10 trousers he has to pay. 12 shirts and 10 trousers. Together he is going to buy them together. Okay, 12 shirts and 10 trousers. So how much rupees he has to pay? Will you multiply 12 by 600 and 10 by 1400? Or what we are going to do? First, as there is discount on the pair, shirt and trouser, there is discount on the purchasing the shirt and trouser together. So in PC, how many such pairs we can find? How many such pair of shirt and trouser we can find in these 12 shirts and 10 trousers? How many pairs? 12 shirts are more than trousers, so all trousers we can use here for the pairs. So there are 10 trousers and 12 shirts. So from these 12 shirts, 10 shirts we use here to form pairs. Okay? So 10 trousers plus 10 shirts means total how many pairs we are able to form? 10 pairs, correct? 10 pairs of shirt and trousers we are getting here. Okay? 10 trousers and 10 shirts. total means 10 pairs. Okay, 10 pairs of shirt and trousers you are getting here. So, one pair of shirt and trousers cost will be 1800, that is 1800. And 10 pairs, how many? So, see, a pair of shirt plus shirts. Shirts is the word which is always in plural. A pair of shirts plus trousers. It is also, it should be also in plural. Why it is in plural? Though it is one shirt, a trouser, why it should be, why it is in plural? Find out that. A pair of shirts plus trousers is equal to rupees 1800. Then how many pairs we have got here? In 12 shirts and 10 trousers we have got 10 pairs of shirts and trousers. So, 10 pairs of shirts plus trousers is equal to how many? One pair of shirts and trousers rupees 1800. And 10 pair of shirts and trousers, what we are going to do to find that 10, we are going to multiply this rupees 1800 by 10. Okay, so there are zeros at the end. How many? You have 1, 2 zeros, you have 1 zero. Total 3 zeros right here. And 18 ones are 18. Rupees 18,000. And now see, when out of 12 shirts, 10 shirts were taken here to form pair with the 10 trousers, then how many shirts remain here? 2 shirts remain. That 2 shirts we cannot form pairs with the trousers, right? Then what we are going to do? This cost of these 2 shirts we are going to count separately. So, 1 shirt cost rupees 600, then 2 shirts also, cost of 2 shirts is equal to, cost of 1 shirt is rupees 600, so cost of 2 shirts is rupees 600 multiplied by 2, that is 6 to the 12 and these 2 zeros. Rupees 1200. So total how much he has to pay? That person has to pay total how much? Total cost. Means total cost of 12 shirts and 10 trousers is, add this. I write this here. 0, 0, 2, 1. Okay. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 2, 2, 8 plus 1, 9, and 1. Rupees 19,200. Total he has to pay rupees 19,200. Okay? If he purchased 12 shirts and 10 trousers and using this discount with the pair, he has to pay total 19,200 rupees. Okay? So this is quite lengthy examples. Understand it. Understand all the conditions given in the problem and then go for the solution. You can find by yourself also, by your own method also. Okay, so thank you today. Thank you for today. Have a nice day.